back here. I will be back here. I will be back with another vengeance.
We'll lick our wounds. We'll get over this. We'll be fired up for next year.
Garoppolo has time. Stands in. Going deep. Going for it. Oh, and it's caught for the touchdown. On fourth down, Deebo Samuel for six. Garoppolo's got all day. He's going to launch it deep down the field. Going for it all. And getting it. Sanders, not touched, still on his feet, inside the 10, and he scores! 75-yard bomb from Jimmy Garoppolo to Emmanuel Sanders. Wilson, pressure off the edge, releases it, and it is intercepted by Greenlaw. Trey Greenlaw, now on the return, as he's still on his feet with blockers in front. Trey Greenlaw down the sideline. Can you believe this?
Looks like football, baby.
Pass is caught. Kittle breaks one tackle. Another. Wow, what a touchdown for George Kittle. Throws it. It's intercepted. It's picked off by Warner. Jeff Wilson has come in at running back. Garoppolo's throw is caught by Jeff Wilson. He's going to score a touchdown for the 49ers.
And the pass is going to be picked off by Bosa. Nick Bosa. Can't bring him down till he gets to the 8-yard line. Wow.
Now Evans in the slot. Winston picked off. Richard Sherman, who did not have an interception last year, and he returns it all the way for a 49ers touchdown, 32 yards.
Garoppolo fires. It is caught. Still on his feet is Kittle with a big play and the stiff arm. George Kittle, flags fly. He's down to the 30. What a run by George Kittle. Taking on everybody.
Hey, gold-blooded cunts. This is the gold-blooded fucking podcast. And our team's a mess. What the fuck? Fuck, shit, fuck. Well, they did not beat the Seattle Seahawks. I am Daddy, and I am sad. I am joined by Rob. He is probably angry. Are you angry or sad?
Neither.
Neither. Okay. We are also joined by Michael.
Disappointed.
Disappointed? Okay. It was clear that game, right? It was pretty clear. Like, it was, I didn't feel like we had much hope at all.
Well, I mean, we started the game with Nick Mullins as our quarterback and
our
top three running backs not in the game and our top three wide receivers not in the game and our best offensive player. Our tight end not in the game. So
I guess in hindsight, to only lose by 17 ain't that bad.
Yeah, it was way worse than that too.
Yeah, I know. How you doing, Michael?
Joe, how do you feel? How do you feel about Shanahan signing so many white wide receivers?
I think it's got something to do with, like, he's trying to help younger versions of himself. You know?
Yeah, I don't think that's it at all. Okay. I think it's all we had that knew the plays, to be perfectly honest. I think they all got beat out by the black wide receivers that were on the roster that got taken away from us because of whatever is happening with COVID tests, and all he had left that knew the plays were white guys. That's my take on it.
All right, well...
Yeah.
I think the amount of times that Trent Taylor has been throwing the ball this year proves that he's not a big fan of white wide receivers either.
Yeah, Trent Taylor could fuck off anyhow.
Yeah, he's toast.
Yeah.
Oh, right, no.
But hold on.
He's going to be missing third down, man.
No, he's a fucking joke. Listen, let's back up here.
If everyone was healthy, he's probably not on the team anymore. Him and Dante probably got shipped off in the same boat.
Yeah. That's who I want to talk about is Dante, because we didn't get to talk about the video. I think somebody emailed it to us. Him and his girlfriend made a video of like celebrating the fact that he got cut and signed by the Giants. And it's like, did you see it, Kern?
I just saw the headline today. Did not. I should have watched it.
I unfollowed him.
Yeah, no, somebody sent it to us, I'm pretty sure, so we'll get to it in the emails. Okay. If not, we'll have
I did. That's where I saw it.
We'll check it then, but it's very fun. I mean, I guess I don't have to talk about it if we're going to do it then, but it's worth a... I mean, the ball's on this guy, you know? Like, celebrating anything. Are we going to watch it now?
No.
I clicked the wrong thing. All right. Well, then I guess since we'll talk about him when we do that, then fuck him. The guy sucks anyway. I know you're going to do this, but are you mad about how the Kendrick Bourne thing played out?
No.
Okay.
No, I don't fall into that camp. You know, a lot of people say if it was someone else, if it was this, if it was that, that's not why we lost this game, first of all. And second of all, I would be more mad if there was a different precedent set right now. And losing three guys or whatever it was is not a reason to cancel a game.
Okay. I mean, no, but what I'm saying is it doesn't seem like he even had the COVID.
Yeah, no, I think it's a bullshit thing that COVID is a thing, because if they're asymptomatic and they're testing negative and they're testing now he's positive again.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh. So who the fuck knows? He just tested positive again today or yesterday. So who the fuck knows? Maybe he was positive all along. You know, who knows anything? Who knows the reliability of any of these tests right now?
This sucks.
You know?
I hate him. I hate the world. But before you get into this, fuck Donald Trump. That's what we gotta say.
Yeah, I would slow down. I mean, Al Gore thought he was president for a month and a half.
Years,
however long ago. So
I don't think Trump's getting this one.
Yeah, I don't know.
Fuck him.
I'm not gonna get into politics. I'm not celebrating the other piece of shit that's now our leader.
Yeah, I'm not that.
That guy's garbage, too.
Yeah, I know. I don't give a fuck about that. That's why I said fuck Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Fuck him. He's a dick. Mike Pence is a creep.
Yeah. Couldn't agree more. And Joe Biden's a piece of shit, and Kamala Harris is a piece of shit.
Yeah.
We're fucked.
Well, yeah, but at least...
we're fucked. I'll vote for Kern right now. I'll tell you that, right? I'll put this out there. If you put John Lynch or Kyle Shanahan on the ballot, I would vote for them right now, because I'm confident that they're smarter than any of the four people on either side of this.
Let me ask you a serious question.
Like, and I'm being funny and joke, but I'm dead serious that I think that both Kyle Shanahan and John Lynch are smarter people than the four people at vice president and president that ran in this election. I 100% believe that.
Let me ask you a question. Hypothetical scenario. Completely, never in a world could this ever happen, but let's just pretend.
I love that you're prefacing that when we all hear it and we're going to know that it's not possible. That's my favorite part.
Okay. So,
go ahead.
Everyone in America has cast their vote for president. Okay. You are the last vote.
Okay.
All right. There's two teams. One is the current team, Trump Pence.
Okay.
Oh, it's a deadlock.
What?
It's deadlock. And Rob knows this. Just. Easy. You're vice president in this scenario.
So my vote is the final one.
You're the sayer. I am president. Michael Kern's the vice president. Who do you vote for?
I worked in the hospital through the whole pandemic.
That doesn't mean anything. The only question I have is, do we have our current relationship still?
Yes.
Oh, then I 100% vote for you. Because fuck the rest of the world. It's going to benefit me tenfold.
100%. Yeah, nothing's changed.
Yeah, I don't have to go to work tomorrow.
No.
Done. I would literally just fund
sign
money,
my fucking vote up.
Cabinet member 101.
Fund money to Rob, and then I would fund money to the tattoo shop if he wants it. If he still
wants
it.
You don't even have to sell it.
I'm just going to go take it all from a bank, and you're going to pardon me. It doesn't matter.
It's good. Yeah, well, listen, you're going to...
You guys won't have to do anything except say, yep, he's pardoned. I'll just go take all the money.
You're going to be working. I can assure you that. The country's not going to run itself, my friend. You know? Somebody's got to get this fucking...
So basically I'm voting for myself. Is that what you're saying? I don't want that job. Don't get me wrong.
You got to consider all sides here.
I will tell you this. I would vote for Dwayne The Rock Johnson over both people that ran this time.
Mm-hmm.
I already said Shanahan and Lynch. I would vote for Well, let me think. I'm going to go opposite. I'm going to go someone that I probably don't even like.
Okay.
Let me think.
It's a, you know who I
Bill, I'd vote for Bill Belichick over both that ran.
That'd be funny. Yeah,
I would vote for...
I think my father should be the president.
I'd vote for him.
Yeah.
I'd vote for your father over both of them.
Yeah.
And he's conservative, too.
Yeah.
He's definitely conservative.
Yeah, he's a conservative. I might vote. He's an asshole, but I think he'd get it right.
Yeah. He would definitely fuck up. He'd have a scandal, for sure.
Oh, of course. It'd be a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But an adult woman.
Yeah, yeah. Oh,
which
yeah,
is
yeah.
better than underage yeah. Bill Clinton.
But she might be 25.
That's fine.
Yeah.
It's legal.
What, Clinton was underage?
Well, he's been to Epstein's Island.
Oh, right on.
That's all I need to hear.
You're, you mean now? Like, the Clinton scandal now. Not Clinton scandal when he was in office.
Well, I think he was going then, too.
Right, but we just didn't know it then. Yeah, yeah.
Do you want more? You want more people I'd vote for?
I mean...
I'd vote for Roger Goodell over the two people that I have.
Ooh.
Yeah, who's the... Who's
not
the
over...
Emailer?
I wouldn't vote for Goodell over your father or Lynch or Shanahan
yes.
or
Thank
Dwayne
you.
Johnson. But over Biden and Trump, I would.
Okay.
Bernie Sanders, I'd vote for him over them too. I wasn't a big Bernie Sanders guy.
Yeah.
I'd vote for Joe Rogan over both of them.
Yeah, I agree. You know, all of these choices.
Yep.
I'd vote for my sister too.
She'd
be a good president.
Yep, I'd vote for her.
She'd be a good bitch president.
This was my analogy. I work at a small company.
Yeah.
Doesn't really do anything like political or major in the world, you know. Make some good money. It's a decent sized company.
Some people live a nice life. Yeah,
it's a couple million dollar company. Whatever. There's at least three people in the management ranks that I would vote for over the two candidates that we have, and that's just like a run of the mill company.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which means there's millions of people that I would vote for.
Yeah,
instead of these two.
Yeah.
So, and I'll tell you this too. This is probably going to be a problem, but I'm going to say it anyway.
Ooh.
I see a lot of people that want to talk trash on people for not voting, and I'm going to go the opposite. I did not vote, and I think if you voted, that you're contributing to the problem of these two parties by voting for one of them. And this lesser of two evils is not – that's not how we run a country. That's not how I choose – to run a country. That's not how I choose to pick my leader as the lesser of two evils. I choose to not pick one of them two. I will say I didn't help by voting a third party, but if we stopped doing this and started voting differently, we wouldn't have to do this.
So I'll say,
it doesn't make sense to me.
I'll say this. In 2016, I voted for a third party, somebody else, you know? I just feel at this point, I feel Trump is such a cancer that we need a better starting platform. And if this is the avenue, and I hear, unfortunately, the lesser of the two evil argument, unfortunately, yeah, that's, for me, that's where it's at. I feel that guy is that big of a cancer. So in 4 more years, I will go back to voting for the third party.
Do you think that it was worth at least this year to get Trump out of office, to then get, I understand why
no.
I vote for the lesser of the two evils, but at least to get him out.
No.
Then
I don't think there's any way to know that right now.
One side was definitely.
I don't think there's any way to know that now. I think I can answer that question in 4 years.
Yeah, if COVID really goes away and things
are
great.
Who knows? I mean,
yeah.
If we go to complete fucking shit show
yeah.
with this fucking retard,
either
I'm gonna
way.
Go, no.
Yeah.
no.
Either way,
worth,
right.
You know
yeah,
what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So
that's true.
And even still, I won't know because it could have been a bigger dumpster fire with the other moron. So there's really no way I'm going to know, you know? I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm certainly not saying that I did the right thing. That's for damn sure. Don't ever look at me for the right fucking decision.
Right, but...
Especially political. I mean, not
yeah,
you. I'm just saying
yeah, no,
me
as
well.
I agree.
That's our choice.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, well, this is...
I think talking trash about someone that didn't vote is the same people that talk trash about Colin Kaepernick.
Probably.
We live here, and the great thing that about living here is that you can vote if you want. You don't have to.
Yeah.
You can vote this way. You can vote that way. You can take a knee if you want. You could burn a flag if you want.
Yeah.
You're a piece of shit, but you can do
it.
I
was very close to not voting, believe it or not. And Jessica was like, she was the one that like actually kind of like pushed me. She's like, hey, whatever. Whatever she said to me. And
you think we should just delete this and go back and start with the injury so people actually listen to us?
No, people...
Maybe.
People don't care what we have to say.
I think people want to... Yeah, well, actually,
well,
I think...
We should have started with a disclaimer.
It,
don't
like,
Don't take advice from any of us. We're actual morons.
Yeah, well, we can get into that.
We're paying to talk to you right now.
Yeah.
And to record this podcast. We're like legitimate morons. Like, don't listen to us. Like, we're dumb humans.
We've barely gotten to this far.
We get together every week for hours on end, late at night, to talk about a football team that has literally no starters left playing.
Yeah.
And we pay to put that out there for you people to listen to our idiot opinions.
Yeah.
We should not be listened to for any level of advice. And we're actual idiots.
Well, politically, we give pretty good life advice, but that's not what this is about. Yeah, I mean,
allegedly.
Yeah, if you were to like call us and tell us something's wrong with your car, we'd probably be able to diagnose it.
At least steer you in the right direction. If you had an electrical problem, we could probably walk.
Yeah,
you through
I could definitely walk you through that. Yeah,
we have some.
There's
some
a couple
good
things we could do. Yeah,
not life choices or political decisions. Don't look for us.
We'll beat up your daughter's boyfriend. I'll bury your dog.
This is either going to be the worst episode we've ever had, or it's
I hope somebody's ranking them. All right, well, why don't we get into this 49ers?
Yeah, we're gonna run out of time before I get through this list. All right,
is this ever gonna end?
Let's start with before the game. Debo Samuel hamstring, did not play. We might see him against the Saints. Tevin Coleman did not play this week. Kwaski Tart did play. Richie James did play with the ankle, thank goodness. Kendrick Bourne tested positive for COVID-19, was placed on the COVID-19 reserve list. This is all before the game. Left tackle Trent Williams, wide receiver Brandon Ayuk, and wide receiver Debo Samuel were all placed on the COVID-19 reserve list because of close contact with Kendrick Bourne.
They all live together, huh?
I think that's what it seems like.
That's weird. Imagine living in that house.
Jordan Reed with the knee was activated off IR, and he played this week. Jimmy Garoppolo and George Kittle were officially put on IR. Offensive lineman Tony Bergstrom and running back Austin Walter were activated from the practice squad. Wide receiver River Craycraft, safety Jonathan Cyprian, tight end Daniel Helm, and wide receiver Kevin White were all activated from the practice squad as COVID-19 replacements. That's like a special designation because the COVID-19 guys, it's like a short term.
Yeah. I wonder if they make more money. Probably, right?
Yes, actually, we'll get into that.
Okay.
Defensive lineman Josiah Kataney was signed to the practice squad. Wide receiver Chris Fink was released from the practice squad. And Akello Witherspoon was a healthy scratch.
You ever watch the show Escaping Polygamy?
No.
Ooh, fucking people are
fucked. Say Witherspoon was a healthy scratch because of we needed to make sure that we had, special teams help. Shanahan was saying what they do is they pick all the starters, get the first spots, and then they look at special teams, and that's how they fill the backup spots. So if Witherspoon's not as good on special teams as whoever the other backup would be, let's say Dante Johnson or whoever it is, then that person will get the start because of being a gunner or whatever they need on special teams.
Gotcha.
Two injuries during the game. Kwaski Tart went out with a foot injury. Turned out to be turf toe. So we will not be seeing him for a couple weeks.
That's the Patrick Willis killer.
Yep.
Oh, no.
K'Wan Williams left with a high ankle sprain, so he's out this week. I'm guessing that'll be a couple weeks, too.
What the? Does it ever end?
No, it doesn't. Some roster updates after the game. Wide receiver River Craycraft and safety Jonathan Cyprian were promoted to the active roster. They had the short-term COVID one, so when the COVID guys came off of that list, they went back to the practice squad. Now they're actually activated as regular active players.
Well, I didn't get to see this, but what is the skin tone of River Craycraft?
Didn't we go through this?
Not River.
I thought we did. No, Karn?
No, we did.
Oh, fill me in.
He's white.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there's not many black guys named River. Cornerback Richard Sherman, we opened his practice window this week. I don't think we'll see him this week.
No,
in the group chat, I was like, there is not a single.
Hey, your internet connection sucks. You should probably go back to 2.4. Or tell your girlfriend that she can FaceTime on her phone. Get her off the Wi-Fi.
Give it a boot. Give it a
Hope
boot.
Hope she doesn't listen because you're going to be in trouble.
Give it a boot.
Sherman, we opened the practice window. I don't think we'll see him this week. I think that's just to get him practicing. I figure after this game, we have the bye. We might see him the week after that against the Rams. That's probably Just to get him a bunch of practice before the Rams.
49ers designate Richard Sherman for a return from IR. Okay.
Yeah, that's open his practice.
Okay. I just don't know. You know, all these different wordings confuse a simpleton like me.
Wide receiver Chris Fink was signed back to the practice squad after he was released off the practice squad before the game. And then today, wide receiver Kendrick Bourne was again placed on the reserve COVID-19 list. The problem is, if he does live with those guys, they might have to go back on again.
That sucks.
I mean, it's early enough that if they get some negatives, they can get back in time.
Hopefully. Yeah, it is Tuesday.
So you asked about money.
Yeah.
So every time you promote someone from the practice squad, it costs money. Because you have to bring them up to league minimum.
Okay.
That is one of the reasons we traded Quan Alexander. We were out of money. We had $0 cap space.
Okay.
So when we traded Quan, it opened up some cap space to allow us to bring these guys up.
Gotcha.
All this movement from practice squad to active roster costs money every single time we do it. So in order to keep enough players to even have a team on the field, we had to free up money to make those payments.
Gotcha.
That also...
Wow. That's so dicey, isn't it?
That's also one of the reasons that Dante Pettis got cut. Was to free up that money also. That's money freed up to pay these guys. That's why you're probably not going to see us put in a waiver claim on Tack. What's his name? Tack, whatever, just got released from Atlanta. You're probably not going to see us put a waiver claim on him.
Oh, the guy that Steve sent the thing on? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we could use the pass rush, obviously. He seems to be a locker room issue. He seemed to cause problems over there in Atlanta. But also, we just don't have the money. We need the money to keep promoting these guys to the active roster. It's just not going to happen, I don't think. We'd have to cut somebody or trade some money away to have any shot to sign someone. I just don't see it happening. If we were like closer to having a run at the division, maybe, or something like that.
Right. Even if somebody else had to get, you know, something.
The NFL did announce today that if they do have to cancel games, all the owners have agreed to add a playoff team in both conferences.
Wow.
So that could be us. There's a very good chance we're on that.
In that bubble, if we can get some guys back, yeah.
Well, this week's going to be rough. After that, maybe we can get some wins, but
yeah,
it's going to be a rough one. I'm not saying we can't win this week, but
Cowboys
almost beat the Steelers.
That was fun to watch.
That was real fun to watch. Really, I called that game as soon as it started. I was with a Cowboys fan who was down and out, and I said, "This is the perfect trap game." I go that, first of all, the Steelers are already looking through them. There's no way the Steelers are taking that team seriously with Garrett, whatever his name is, a quarterback that no one's ever heard of. And the thing with that guy is, if you're his coach, you go to the guy and you say, "Hey, guess what? Come out of this game with a win, and every single person in this country knows your name tomorrow."
Yeah.
Every person, every single football fan in America,
they're talking about you on
everywhere.
Yeah,
and if he doesn't throw that pick in the red zone, they probably win that game.
I couldn't even watch the fucking end of our game. A couple other NFL things I want to talk about before we get to this debacle. How about the Jets almost beating the Patriots and then losing it,
and trying to get Darnold back for their next game? They don't even want to win.
They're
too afraid that Flacco's going to get him a win by accident. They got to put Darnold back out there.
So Flacco just passed Montana for most yards. Fucking horse shit.
Guess what he didn't pass Montana for?
Yeah, Super Bowl
most
wins.
Rings.
Yeah. Dick size. I guess that's it. And it's amazing that the Dolphins are winning as well. So I will be completely honest with you, gold-blooded motherfuckers. I went to sleep in the third quarter. I just shut my eyes and didn't give a fuck anymore. I stopped fighting it. So I don't really know what happened after
the third quarter.
I didn't
watch the end either, to be honest.
Kern, did you watch the entirety?
I watched the entire thing. Come on, guys.
I fell asleep. I didn't care.
I think I passed out on the couch. I didn't like get up and go to bed, but
yeah,
I was out. I was way over it.
I woke up on the couch at about 3 a.m. cranky with a cat on my head, and I took it to the bed. That was that. Well, what did you think of the whole game, Michael?
It fucking sucked. I wish I didn't watch the whole thing.
It was terrible.
No, I mean, it was just... It was good watching. I don't know if you guys saw, but towards the end, Richie James had a couple of you know, the defense wasn't trying to let the huge play go, so they were giving a lot of leverage to the wide receivers. But Richie James was making a lot of plays, a lot of deep throw catches, and other than that, the game sucked.
He had 184 yards?
Yeah.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
That's insanity. You know what?
The tragedy of this game, here's the tragedy
of Richie James.
You just totally cut out. Stand by. Go, Rob.
The tragedy of this game is that if this COVID situation didn't happen,
yeah,
even if it did happen with Kendrick Bourne,
mm-hmm.
but if Brandon Ayuk played in this game, Brandon Ayuk is the front runner for rookie of the year right now.
Yeah, he would have 200 yards.
No fucking way, at least.
Yeah.
At least, because he would have broke more tackles, he would have caught all those balls, and those plays were designed for him.
Right.
Shanahan had a whole game plan that was, he said 80% Brandon Ayuk, 20% Kendrick Bourne, something like that. And then it just got pushed to Richie James and everyone else, whoever everyone else is, when they were out. But I'm telling you that Brandon Ayuk would be a household name today if he was playing, and he would be the front runner for rookie of the year.
Let me ask you another question. Do you think that, because when Trent Taylor, like when he first got here, he had some skills. There was hype behind him. Do you think the injuries have completely derailed his career?
Trent Williams?
Trent Taylor.
Oh, Trent Taylor?
The wide receiver.
Yeah, injuries. Yeah, being out 2 years with injuries.
Like, he's just done. Like, I don't think he'll ever be...
Well, he also...
He'll never be the Wes Welker. He'll never be the guy he was supposed to be.
When he turned it on, most of that was with Jimmy, right?
He had a connection
with Jimmy.
Yeah.
They had a pretty good connection when Jimmy first got here.
Yep.
I don't know what happened to him, to be honest. But I think Richie James is going to take that spot from him. And he already, I think Kendrick Bourne already had it, but Richie James out of the slot, Richie James can play in the slot really well. And I don't think, I think that's what we wanted Trent Taylor to do. And I think we've all seen that Shanahan likes a guy that can go anywhere, which is Debo and Brandon, and it looks like Richie James, because he was out wide and in the slot in that game.
Okay, you know, you go a couple games without Debo being in there, and then when you see he's such a fucking force.
And he was hurt. He was, like, still not
well. I know. I can't wait for him to get back. He's such a fucking savage. Fuck!
Oh, dude. I should have got I got to get the recording for you. I got to find it.
Of what?
It's a teaser. I'll bring it up next episode.
Oh, we got a teaser.
Oh, you're going to love it.
I'm getting teased.
If I can find it, I'll have it this episode.
I don't like this. I don't like getting teased. I like it all now. Like I said earlier, it never felt like the Niners had a chance with this one. That fucking Metcalf, is that his name? Metcalf? Somebody? Metcalf. Anybody? The monster wide receiver?
On the
Seahawks?
Yeah, you're talking about 2 games ago.
Oh, this is the Packers game. Holy shit. I don't remember this.
This was Devontae Adams.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. I don't remember this game. I was fucking... Yeah. Once a year, I do this. I'll completely block out a game. Once a year.
You don't want to hear about Aaron Rodgers, but Devontae Adams is not Devontae Adams if it's not Aaron Rodgers throwing him that ball.
Yeah.
Tell you that right now.
Yep.
I'm sorry, I'm piecing it all together now.
And I'll also tell you, if you switch Nick Mullins and Aaron Rodgers, that game is probably a different outcome.
I don't know with the Niners. I don't think Aaron Rodgers could help that lineup. You genuinely think Aaron Rodgers could help that? Who's he going to throw to?
I don't know, but he's like Tom Brady. He makes wide receivers.
There was nobody out there. They had Ogilvy, or who the fuck, exactly.
Ogilvy.
Yeah. Ogilvy.
Goddamn Ogilvy.
Ogilvy Jones, 81.
Oh, I can't wait to find this clip for you.
Oh my God, I don't
want to interrupt the show anymore. I'll do it in the break for next time.
I don't believe I totally blocked this game out. Wow. It was that bad.
So which game did you go to sleep for?
This game. This game for sure. Wow. I was thinking Russell Wilson in my head. Like, I totally...
This game was terrible. This was there was no fun in watching this.
Then I don't feel bad.
It was blown out from the start. It didn't. I mean, the Seattle game felt like we had a shot for a little while.
Yeah,
this game didn't feel that way. This was quickly a bad fucking day for us.
Yeah, apparently me too. We were all off. Holy fuck!
I mean, when they scored a touchdown on the first drive, I was like, oh, here we go. And then we punted, and then I got really nervous. When we drove, we got the field goal to make a 7-3. I went, okay. And, you know, it was going okay. They punted again. It's 7-3, and Nick is moving them down the field. And it looks like it's going to be a game. And then Mullins throws the interception. Oh. And it's all fucking downhill from there. That interception was the end of the fucking game, as far as I'm concerned.
Can Jerick McKinnon fuck off or what?
Yeah, I think, I mean, that wasn't him. That was a bad throw.
No, I mean, I don't mean there. I mean, in general. Like, with everybody hurt, you figure, and they're literally being. What I do remember about this game was because Trent Williams didn't play, there was like, they moved around the offensive line, right?
Yeah, which was a fucking shit
show. A nightmare, right? Yeah, see, I remember that.
I think, so McKinnon had 12 carries for 52 yards. I'm not mad at that.
Yeah.
He also had 3 catches for 16.
Okay.
He was our second best offensive weapon.
Okay.
I was more disappointed in Hasty. I thought maybe he should have got a bigger chance to see if he could do something with it, but
did he fumble again or no?
No, I think it was just that we got behind and started throwing the ball. What were you saying, McKinnon? Oh, the offensive line.
Yes.
I think my opinion is listening to Shanahan talk, my opinion is they're looking for someone to play center so they don't have to re-sign Weston Richburg. I think he's becoming a free agent. Can you check on that, Kern?
I'll look.
I think he's becoming a free agent this year, and I think that they would love for Brunskill to step up into that position. He was the backup. He did a little bit during OTAs, and then he played this week at center, and I think they would really like him to slide into that spot so they don't have to re-sign Richburg.
It seemed to be okay,
or they could
trade
Richburg with the injuries and the money. He got paid pretty good. It might be a release deal.
And that other guy's a beast.
And they got to pay Trent Williams if they want to keep him. Trent Williams is a 1-year deal.
Yeah.
Like, that's it. At the end of this year, he's a free agent. So if we want to keep him, we're going to have to pay him.
And what a waste.
Where the fuck is that money going to come
and
from?
And what a waste this year was with him, you know?
So it gets weird. We got to pay a lot of people. So
yeah.
Start looking for roster moves because they're coming.
And then you plan on having a full draft class, so you'll have to pay for that. Great. Well, I'm glad I don't have those problems.
So Weston Richburg,
yeah,
5-year, $47 million deal. Average salary is 9.5 a year.
So is he here next year then? Next year is his fourth year in the team.
Signed through what year?
Yep.
Next year is his last year.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Look for a trade this offseason. That's my prediction.
Yeah, because the last years are usually heavy, right, contract-wise?
Yeah, and if somebody needs a center bat and he's a veteran with a good pedigree, I think that's how we got that's how we got Trent Williams. Last year of his deal, we needed a left tackle. That's just a feeling I got. Something about that made me feel that way. Oh. And if we had Garland and Brunskill.
And then the Hronis.
Garland played okay.
What about Hronis Nasu? Is that his name?
Grasu
Naronis. All right, well, now that we're all on the same page, we know what game we're talking about. You want to do the blame game? You want to do that now?
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to blame myself. I just didn't have it. I didn't bring my A game. I didn't even know what the fuck we were talking about. I failed the people of this podcast as well as the team.
That's easy
one for me this week. It's my fault.
Man, I don't know where to go with this one.
Curran, do you have somebody?
I don't. The whole game was just a shit show, and I don't know. I blame. I don't know his name, but whoever did not draft Aaron Rodgers to this team to begin with.
Mike Nolan was the head coach.
I disagree with that, because if we had drafted Aaron Rodgers, we probably don't have Kyle Shanahan today.
But we would
have. If I got to pick one, I'll take Kyle Shanahan.
You think we would have had a Super Bowl, though?
Maybe. Aaron's got one.
Right.
If
we had two shots without him.
He comes here, though.
You know? And in my opinion, we had two winnable shots without him.
Extremely. We should have won both those motherfuckers.
Yeah. And that's without Aaron Rodgers. And I think we have a longer future with Shanahan than Rodgers right now.
Oh, for sure now, but yeah, I mean, who's to say? In the last decade. But in the same sense, Rodgers also could have won more than one. Probably should have, too.
Yeah, I don't like McCarthy at all. I don't think.
No, yeah, he was a fuck. Yeah, that was terrible for him.
I think if LaFleur got in there sooner, they might have even had more, to be honest. I my personal opinion is that the next generation, like my kids, are going to look at Kyle Shanahan the way people look at Bill Walsh. That's my opinion. Or Bill Belichick.
I hope so.
That's my opinion. I think this offseason is going to make or break that, because I don't know what – I think next year is going to make or break that.
I bet we could still have had Kyle Shanahan.
Yeah, I just don't think the pieces would have fell in. I think when you're winning, you don't go out and like make that extra – that's why the Packers stuck with McCarthy as long as they did, because they're always competitive because of Aaron Rodgers.
Just couldn't get it done.
We could be in some sort of a rut right now, and then we fire the head coach.
It's possible. It's always, anything's GM is possible
at that point. So that's why I'm going for I'm going to go for that as my blame game, though.
That's fair. I'm gonna go with I don't know. I don't have any idea. I'm gonna redeem myself right now. I'm gonna blame Donald Trump.
My man.
If Donald Trump had done a better job in the beginning of COVID, our players would have been able to have OTAs. They would have been able to practice.
We would have gone to England.
They wouldn't be hurt as much. We wouldn't have lost these four players this game.
Amen.
We would have got to go watch football games in person. We could have cheered on our team. We would have had a home field advantage in Santa Clara. The fans could have been into it. I'm blaming Donald Trump.
We would have been at three games already this year.
Yep. They're talking about fans at the Saints game now, too.
Oh.
That's a fucking kick in the dick.
What do you got to ruin my... Every time I come here, I get worse news.
Yeah, and don't look for any time soon in California. Although the governor okayed it. It was the county, right?
Yeah, the county shut it down. Yeah. All right, so I guess you want to try to do Beast of the Week?
I mean, is there a question on either one?
I guess not. Jesus
Christ. I only gave you one choice.
Yeah, okay.
You could write it if you want.
No, but I'll read it for everybody. So that's what I'll do. So here we go. The offensive Beast of the Week in a unanimous decision.
A unanimous.
It's Richie James Jr. He's got 9 receptions for 184 motherfucking yards, which is more than half of Nick Mullins' yards for the game.
I think he even had a drop or two, too. That's the best
part. I was just saying, I think I saw a drop. and he had a touchdown for good measure.
He was targeted 13 times.
Oh, okay.
You want to laugh? Look up Trent Taylor's receptions versus targets on the season. Not pretty.
Oh, on the season?
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Not good.
Oh.
On the season?
Yep. You can go ahead with the
defense. Okay.
It's going to probably take him a minute.
Yeah, you worked that out. Defensive Beast of the Week is Mr. Steady Freddy, Dick Like a Concrete Truck, Fred Warner. He will plow the fuck out of you with that thing. That mushroom tip.
You know what? This might be a good time right now. While you're looking up, oh, here it is. I got it right here. He's been targeted 21 times. Guess how many receptions he has?
Yeah, I read it. I just didn't want to. I didn't want to say it. I've read it.
I guess.
I saw it. He has 10 receptions. 10. He's dropped 11 balls. He can go. That's not injury. That's just weak.
Not good.
That's weak boy. That's weak little boy shit.
Little pee-pee.
That's Dante Pettis shit.
That's little pee-pee
shit. Let's go fuck yourself shit.
Maybe now's a good time to go over our bold predictions for the year.
Okay. Why? What do we got? Did you get another one?
No. My first one's probably way shot.
Oh.
This isn't a good time.
Yeah, it is. I see why. Michael Curran said, with bold confidence, Trent Taylor leads the league for third down conversions, and Bosa will be the defensive player of the year with 21 sacks. Well, Mike.
I jinxed both of them.
Well, I mean, Rob also said Jimmy G was going to have over 4,000 yards. He's hitting it out of the park with Freddie Warner, but...
You know, just me and Aaron Rodgers on the same page, that's all.
Yeah. Yeah. Are we going to... We don't need to play that, do we?
No.
Okay, good.
I'm sure every 49ers fan in America has listened to that clip.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
All right.
Our bold NFL predictions, however...
You know, I'm looking good on that.
Yep. I was going to say, so the only one that's definitely a no-go is mine. Seattle's pretty much already in the playoffs.
I'm still alive.
So that's pretty much done. Yep. Right? Like, Seattle's going to...
Yeah.
Seattle's in the playoffs.
Yeah, yeah.
The Bills in the Super Bowl is a definite possibility. I wouldn't say it's sure a lock thing. By any stretch.
Yeah.
I think anybody that... If I had to put money on it, I'd say it's them and the Steelers in the AFC Championship, if Ben stays healthy. He took a shot yesterday and was hobbling around. It didn't look good.
No.
But if he stays healthy, I think it's between those two for the AFC right now. And at any moment, and Adam Vinatieri could die from COVID and Joe could get his right.
I forgot about that.
We can only hope.
You also could hit one of your 49er predictions. Bosa's definitely not going to set the single season sack record.
Yeah, but Bourne would really have to light the world on fire.
Well, if nobody else plays, he might.
Yeah, I guess he's got to get.
He's got to lead the team.
He's probably going to get like two more touchdowns, and we got it. By the way, Gabrielle came through.
There you go.
Yeah. Look at me. Even when I fuck up, I made it happen. All right. What's the sheet of direction tell me to do next? outro. Well, what's our time? Oh, look at that. Well, we got to do the particulars here. Hey, cunt bags. If you are a Patreon subscriber and you'd like to watch the game in a Zoom meeting versus the Saints, the first half of the game, why don't you holler at me? We could put that together. This is some of the things we'll give you for being Patreon members. Or you can just keep giving us money. I don't give a fuck. I'll stop attempting to do shit for you. is that the right attitude, Rob?
Go for it.
Yeah, good. Email us and tell me to go fuck myself, goldbloodedpodcast@gmail.com. Check us out on our Instagram. That's Goldblooded Podcast. I got to tell you, on the way here, I was driving on the highway, and I took a slight right turn, and I honestly felt like I took a right turn into hell. And ever since then, I've been like, Kendrick Bourne has how many?
Where'd it go? Where the fuck did it go?
It was all highlighted nice for me.
Yards, 352 receiving yards.
Yeah, I said touchdowns, though.
Oh, so, did you?
Yeah. He only has one. So, well.
Most on the team is two.
So, okay. And I said he'd lead wide receivers. So, okay. We'll see.
That could happen.
Yeah, I felt like I took a turn, and I just felt like I entered another. I felt like I entered another fucking dimension. I'm not even. And ever since then, I've been like in La La Land. I mean, fuck! I thought it was the Packers game, and I wasn't.
Take LSD? What's going on?
No, but it's something weird. Something's going on. I don't know. Maybe baby fucking poisoned me. Instagram. There's a Patreon. Obviously, I don't know who the fuck would want to pay for this fucking. Fucking train fire.
Well, you got to put your deal out. Patreon deal.
Yeah, I'm saying it. Wait, I just said that.
Yeah, no, okay. You said, yeah, I don't know why anybody would want to pay for this dumpster fire. Maybe they want to hang out with you.
Well, no, I already told them to hang. But I said if they don't want to hang out with me, they can all fuck off and die. Or something to that effect. Okay. www.patreon.com/goldbloodedpodcast. Hit us up with the ducats. You know how daddy do. We need the ducats, baby. I think that's it. I don't know. This is probably the most off episode I've ever felt. I feel I'm in bizarre world right now.
A bunch of political talk at the beginning.
Yeah,
a fucking shit show game that we barely talked about. This is definitely the worst episode of the Gold Blooded Podcast.
Yeah, Steve, you bailed at the right time. Fuck. I promise I'll do better next time, Mom. All right, goodbye.